we continue our lesson and let us talk about the time. You certainly know that every second of usual TV movie consists of 25 frames. Similarly, every second of our cartoon is divided into 25 separate pictures. And now, look at the time scale of our timeline. As you remember, we have created a composition for a 1 minute. And now we see this whole minute displayed on the scale. It's not very convenient, because in the animation we more often have to work with seconds and the individual frames. In order to see the seconds and frames, you need to stretch the timeline. For this purpose, in the After Effects, assign the plus and minus keys on the top row of the keyboard. Press the plus and you'll see how the timeline begins to stretch. Here we see the 5 second mark, now already 1 second, and now we see the letter F. F is the frame. Just a couple of steps, and here we clearly see every single frame and can't stretch any longer. To compress the timeline, use the minus key. When the timeline is extended, at the bottom of it, as in usual Windows window, appears a slider that allows you to move to the areas of the timeline that are now hidden. You can move along the timeline using arrow keys and page up and page down keys. Pressing page down key, you'll move to the next frame, and page up will move you 1 frame back. And as usual, home and end keys will move you to the beginning and the end of the timeline. Now, when they get used to the scale of time, we'll continue our fish training and we'll teach her to perform your turn. Let's say our fish swam, and came to the point after which it got to swim back. At this point, we need to turn its head to other side. We can easily do it using the scale parameter, thanks to the fact that this parameter can accept not only positive, but also negative values. Suppose, for example, the head value of scale parameter equal to 100%. Let us change it to negative value, and we'll see how our fish flipped the head to the other side. But to our greatest regret, it simultaneously head turned belly up. This happens because the horizontal and vertical sides of the parameter scale linked by this little chain and changed together. Disable this connection, and then we can change the horizontal and vertical sizes of the object independently of each other. Now we can set for the horizontal size value -100 and for the vertical 100%. And see, the fish turns his head back, but this time it does not show any signs of untimely death. And that's exactly what we needed. Let us repeat our actions. So, you have come to the place where the fish should to be turned around. First, enable the animation for the parameter scale. On the timeline appears a keyframe which recorded the current state of the object. Now push the button page down to move to the next frame. Turn off the connection between the horizontal and vertical size to be able to change them independently, and give the horizontal size the negative value. For example, if you had the dimensions of 30x30%, that now has to be -30x30. That's all. Our fish turned around. Flip through the keys page up and page down to see how graciously she is turning. Now sail on. Our fish swam, and reached the wall of the aquarium, where she again has to be turned around. Animation for the scale we already enabled, so there is no need to touch anything. We just need to add a keyframe to fix the current state of the fish. To work with the keyframes, we have these little arrows with diamond between them, to the left of each parameter for which animation is switched on. By clicking on the arrows, you leap to the next or previous keyframe. If there is no keyframe, you can create it by simply clicking on diamond between the arrows, or delete it if it already is there. And so, create a keyframe for the scale, clicking between the arrows. Now go to the next frame and reset the scale value of 30x30%. Alright, our fish turned back. We taught her remarkably turn around, but she does it too quickly, just in 1 frame. For her to do it more smoothly, spread the max of keyframes for 3, 5 or even 7 frames. But do not choose even values, or in the middle of the turn, fish will disappear altogether. And another little trick. If during the movement of the fish, you'll be slightly altering its horizontal dimension, that it becomes somewhat shorter and longer, it will appear as if fish wags its tail and really swims. Pay attention to an important point. If you work long and hard setting keyframes, and then accidentally turn the animation off by clicking on the stopwatch, all your keyframes will be lost. And even if you turn the animation on, keyframes you had created will not reappear. But don't worry, you do not have to redo all the work. In this case, you'll be saved by the magic key combination for undo of previous action, Ctrl Z. Press it, and all keyframes appears again on their places. And do not forget about this wonderful keys. Once you accidentally deleted or moved anything, immediately press Ctrl Z to return everything as it was. And in the end, we have just to save the content of our composition in the form of the finished film to show it to our friends or put on display on YouTube. This can be done very easily. In the main menu, select the item Composition, Make Movie. And immediately on the timeline panel appears the render key, where we see our track scheduled for rendering. In the settings of the output module, click on the audio output, for our cartoon was with the sound. Click OK and check out exactly where the program will save the output file and its name, so you do not cry, oh, where is my cartoon? Now start the render. Rendering is a complex process, during which the program actually assembles the final video file. This may take some time. For you do not get bored, the program will show you already made frames of your animation, as well as how much time has passed and how much is still left. In the end, computer makes a joyful sound, and this will mean that you have only to find and watch your cartoon. This is the easiest and the most reliable way of rendering. Its only drawback is that the resulting files are sufficiently large in volume. This is because we rendered without compression, but you can easily compress the output file using any converter. I myself used the program from Mart Factory, which is in downloads of our website. It is very easy to use program that does not require any configuration. Simply select what format you want to convert your file in, such as AV for viewing on the computer, or the MP4 or 3GP for mobile devices and phones. Drop your file in the window that opens and remember the folder where to find the target file. Click OK and then start. And after a couple of minutes, you'll get ready file, which you'll be able to upload, for example, to your phone to show your friends. Well, I think you are quite prepared to create your own cartoon about marine life. Among the files for our lesson, you'll find a lot of pictures that will allow you to make a cartoon like this scene from our cartoon The True Story of the Yellow Kalina. Unleash your imagination. Let us see how we'll look on the seabed, cheerful god and dog with its kennel. Dress your favorite heroes in the underwater suit and send them to search the treasures of the sunken ships. And then we will have competition and see who will make more interesting story. Write to us and send us your cartoons. In the next lesson, we'll learn how to make animation of more serious objects with hands, legs, so they can run, jump and talk. See you next time!